Shalom, Rastafari. This isn't the actual matter of the video, but while I'm at it, this is my closet door, and I just wanted to show one of the beginning steps I took to actually learning the Fidel. The Lion of Judah Society, it provides a very good template to actually begin the learning the Imperial Ethiopic, or the Amharic Amareña. Actually, it really does work. That's how I kind of learned it. Not that I'm fluent or I'm really good at it, but at least I can read. First, I did exactly what the LOJ Society steps suggest that we do. I did 11 at a time. And then that's why they're in different colors. Let's see if you can notice. They're in different colors because they're 11, 11, and 11. And then just follow all the process, all the steps. It really does work. And then when you're reading the English Bible right next to the Amharic one, for some reason it feels right. I'm not saying that. Me personally, I mean, it wasn't like I was understanding exactly what I was reading, but something just clicked. Something just felt like if you continue doing it, like, for sure, like, it'll just be natural or something. But that's just my opinion. Another thing is that don't get discouraged if it seems like a lot. It's really simple. I mean, complex matters are pretty simple in reality. You're going to get to see all the patterns and they play out. And so you're going to more or less see all the U's. They pretty much add the same little detail with the exception of maybe a few. But you could kind of... Well, that wasn't even part of the reason I'm doing this. But this is the main reason right here. Just really quickly... The reason I added this a long time ago was because I began reading scripture, and then it was obvious that a lot of the contact that Moses, and even prior to that, Abraham and so on and so forth, that when they came in contact with higher entity, it was obvious that some cases it seemed like encounters with extraterrestrials, you could say. And so I wanted to quickly... Well, when I did this drawing, I wanted people to know, whoever came across it, that it don't matter if, because it looks like a flying saucer, it looks like Saturn with its rings, and then the power of the Trinity, but it doesn't matter, because some people will use UFOs and aliens as an excuse to discredit Jah, right? But it makes it's a logical fallacy. It's misleading. It doesn't even matter, because even if it was so, they too have a creator, and still it is one. And so, but the main reason why I'm showing you this is because now I'm gonna share some really good, well, some good images that Jah provided for I and I, and well, let's get to it. Okay, first I'm gonna go ahead and show off these were taken in May 4th. It was that one night. Hold on for 1 second. It was May 4th. It was like around 10:30 at night, and it was that one night where it was supposed to be a super moon, really big. And although it didn't seem that big where I'm from. In my area, because I guess I was in the city or whatever, but this was later on, and it was the night before Ethiopian Liberation Day, Cinco de Mayo, whatever you want to call it. It was May 5th, and this is just an image, but notice, well, you really can't see that well, because up close it actually looks like Saturn. A bit, kind of like, well, let's see if, well, regardless, that's, just take consider the I guess the rays of light coming off of it, and keep that in mind. Now you see this. I wanted to show this to everyone because you see. Let me turn off the light 1 second. Maybe that will help. Okay, so basically what I wanted to show was that this kind of. This kind of enforces that idea that the universe is spiraling. You see, because it's kind of going like this, and which even the moon, and it creates that right there. I'm sure I didn't explain that well, but I'm not too familiar with this. But now here's the, well, consider the Aztecs or the Mayan, how they refer to the sun as the, as I believe it was Quetzalcoatl, or the feathered serpent, right? And it's because of those I guess I don't know what you call that, radiation beams or whatever, you know, blasting out. Well, where do I start? Let's start with this image. Now these images were taken with my cell phone, and it's not one of those fancy cell phones. It's just whatever, pretty simple. There it is. It's just a random phone. Now, that night, Sunday, May 20th, I believe, there was supposed to be an eclipse. I really didn't see it because I started getting a headache and I was kind of over it. But I did stick my hand up in the air and I took 3 pictures of the sun. And as you can see, this is... Hold on, let me slant that. And I was really surprised because it was barely yesterday I actually saw the pictures, transferred them to the computer, and I was really surprised to what came out. See, right there you can't see anything, but if I kind of shove the screen that way so that you're kind of getting an upside down but looking up diagonal. Oh, my bad. Okay, a diagonal view looking up. If you can notice that... Well, there's a lot of things to notice. Hold on. Let's see if I could get the right angle. This is going to be impossible. Okay, 1 second. Sorry for moving camera around. I'm trying to get that... Boy, I don't think it's gonna work. Apologize. Man. No. Well, I don't know what to say. Okay, let me get the light on. Maybe that'll work. Being a different image and all. Actually, that did work. Okay, well, you can't really see it that well. But there's a circular object right here, kind of. And that in itself, it could be the moon. I'm not sure. I don't know if you can see it right here. I have the little clicker, the hand. And it doesn't agree with the rest of the circumference. And so that in itself is awkward. And then not to mention the rays of the sun and how they're just the way they're positioned. And then I'm sure you all already noticed right in the center. Can you see that? It's as if, hold on 1 second. Well, actually here, you can actually see that, what I was mentioning earlier, the little, like if there's another, see how it doesn't add up with the rest of the sun? And that could very well be the moon, as a matter of fact, but still interesting to note. And then these are the rays, I guess the wings. sticking out from the sun. But then more interesting is this right here. It kind of, that object or whatever it is, it kind of looks like Saturn or like a saucer, you could say. But this one's being cut off already. So, and then you could also see, like, I don't know, I guess the flames of the sun or whatever they call that, the surface. But check it out. And some of these other pics, well, I only got two more, but they're way clearer. Okay, this one's probably the clearest of all. Now, you can clearly see it's like a Saturn type. Okay. See, I want you to get the best image, because if you see this up close, and maybe you'll be able to see it on your screens or something, but you can actually see the colors, like the Ethiopian flag. My aunt actually pointed that out. I was only surprised at that spot in the middle, but my aunt pointed out that they looked like my drawings, and I said, well, what are you talking about? And then she pointed out that if you kind of tilt down and okay, this is actually a stain, all right? So, but this isn't. Okay, well, she mentioned that if you kind of lean down and then look upwards, that you could see the rainbow colors and the frequencies or whatever. But that, I mean, just that in itself, I mean, if someone could explain that, that's pretty, I don't know. I mean, I did not see that when I took the pictures. Like I said, it was way too bright. I just stuck my hand up in the air and I just pressed take picture. But I knew I had to share that with all, because I mean, just it's quite, I mean, I really don't know what to say. Maybe there's like an astronomical, like, I guess, explanation for this, but I myself have no idea and don't have that explanation, and so I leave it up to anyone that knows. And then here's another interesting feature right here. It looks like a moon, like three quarters missing of it, and that's way over here. So already there's a lot of stuff that doesn't really add up, because okay, so we have this object in the center, and then that other round thing, and then this up here. And then, as I'm going to show you the last picture, there's another interesting... Oh, this one's the clearest of all. My bad. This one's... I mean, you don't even have to do much to this one. It's pretty clear what's... Oh, okay. Well, first I'm going to start with this over here. I mean, this in itself is interesting. This right here, it looks like Pac-Man, I guess, in a way. It's weird how there's a tree in back of it, and there's a tree in front of it, and you could tell it has nothing to do with this back here, because the tree shades, well, it's in front of the sun, but then it's in between, and it wasn't dark outside. It's not a light, it's not, I don't know what that is. I just pressed take picture, and that's it. I didn't even see them. And well, just okay, my bad. I mean, what else could I say? You could clearly see that there's like a Saturn type object right there in the middle. I don't know what to make of that. Really interesting. And then this over here, and then you could see that makes it hard to see. That's what I saw. But then I don't know what to make of that. So all Rastafari, this is a gift from Jah to I and I. Meditate upon this. Actually, that night I did some deep meditation, and not that I'm really good at that, but that night was different. And it was actually one of those, we had a, well, my parents had a gathering or whatever the day before. Brother's gonna have a child in a few months. Well, so yeah, let me hear what y'all think. I mean, let me, some comments, some if any of you know what it actually is and what's going on, then it'd be fantastic if someone could illuminate. I, so Shalom Rastafari, Jah bless, guide and protect, I and I. Thank you.